مرجئة. How about those who call Sheikh Albani رحمه الله مرجئ؟ Sheikh Albani رحمه الله, he says الإيمان قول باللسان والاعتقاد بالجنان والعمل بالجوارح يزيد بالطاعة وينقص بالمعصية. Sheikh Albani رحمه الله says that. So how could he be called مرجئ؟ Sheikh Albani رحمه الله, when he mentioned the hadith, look in his checking of Riyad al-Salihin. In his checking of Riyad al-Salihin, when he mentioned that hadith of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, the hadith, إن الله لا ينظر إلى صوركم ولا إلى أجسامكم ولكن ينظر إلى قلوبكم. That's how it's mentioned. Hadith in Sunan al-Tirmidhi, as far as I remember. And it is in Riyad al-Salihin, in the first few chapters. What did Sheikh Albani say in the footnotes? Sheikh Albani, rahimahullah, and it's quoted by one of his students, he says, and there is a riwaya and a ziyada and an additional wording, wa a'malikum. Allahu Akbar. Inna Allah la yanzuru. Allah does not scan, does not look, does not, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not concerned with your appearance, yani your, يعني you have one arm, you have one leg. This is what we mean by appearance, huh? Not the libas, because libas taqwa dalika khair. Allah says the clothing of piety, that is the best. I'm not talking about that. But the fact that you are blind, the fact that you have one ear, one leg, one arm, Allah is not going to question you because of that. Nah. Inna Allah la yanzuru ila suwarikum, your appearance. وَلَا إِلَىٰ أَجْسَامِكُمْ, not your body. وَلَكِنْ يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ قُلُوبِكُمْ. And Sheikh Albani, rahimahullah, painstakingly found a narration with وَأَعْمَالِكُمْ. If it just said, look, he will only look at your heart. That's what the murji'a say, isn't that right? Huh? Iman is only in your heart. That's what the murji'a say. But Sheikh Albani, rahimahullah, showing he's not murji'. Like those people say, the misguided Khawarij, call him Murji', and those who are in their path. Sheikh Albani, rahmahullah, he says, wa a'malikum, meaning it's from Iman. A'mal is from Iman. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, udkhulu al-jannata bima kuntum ta'amaloon. Enter paradise with what you used to do. So this is from Iman. Your a'mal, your actions are from Iman. So therefore, Sheikh Albani, rahmahullah, he already ascertained that. And then he made a footnote as well after that. He said, and not like some of the Moroccans, Magharba. Naam, hakada, he says. Not like some of the Magharba, who it is from their trait to shave their beard. And when it is said to them, no beard, you have no beard, akhi. What do they say? They say, they point to their heart. And Iman is in the heart. So he's refuting who? He's refuting the murji'ah, and those weak Muslims who say Iman is all in the heart. How many Muslims say that nowadays? It's all in the heart. La ya akhi. It's in your heart and in your actions and in your tongue. All three. And it increases with the obedience to Allah and decreases with disobedience to Allah. So Iman is qawlun bil lisan wa amalun bil jawarih wa i'tiqadun bil janan. Janan is your heart. What the hearts contain, your belief, this is also Iman. So Sheikh Albani, rahmahullah, look, he's refuting the Murji'ah. And likewise, in a book which he wrote before his death, rahimahullah, called Dhab an Ahmad, in defense of Imam Ahmad, rahimahullah, in defense of his Musnad, his compilation of about 30,000 hadith or more. The Musnad of Imam Ahmad, rahimahullah. So Imam Ahmad is not only writing books of Aqidah. He has a compilation of Musnad. That compilation of hadith. About 30,000 hadith. Look how these a'imma, they use their time. Not like us, we're sleeping. And we're busy wasting time. The A'imma don't waste time. 30,000 hadith. If we just read, يعني, 1,000 hadith, 10,000 hadith, 5,000 hadith is a ni'mah. 30,000 hadith. with each one of the chain of narration, with each one in order, in a particular order. The Musnad of Imam Ahmad, rahimahullah. They usually call it Musnad because usually they put it in order of names of the narrators. So they will start with the alphabetical order, for example, Abu Bakr, for example, and they put his narrations, and so on and so forth, until they get to the last of the Musnad, which will be the those Asma begin with Ya. No. So, in that book, Sheikh Al-Albani, rahimahullah, again, he refuted those who say that he is Murji. After mentioning a hadith showing clearly that actions are from Iman, he said in a footnote, not like some of the youths who are insulting me, who are claiming that I am Murji. For I have written about this more than 30 or 40 years ago, about this affair, defending the Aqeedah of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah and refuting the Aqeedah of the Murji'ah. And Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen, rahimahullah, says, whoever claims and whoever says that Shaykh Albani, rahimahullah, is Murji', either he doesn't know Albani or he doesn't know Irja'. He doesn't know Albani or he doesn't know Irja'. And Shaykh Muhammad Al-Banna, hafidhahullah, he said, and I say the same. So who is it that accused Shaykh Albani, rahimahullah, of being Murji'? The likes of Safar Al-Hawali, in his book, Zahiratul Irja', he's referring to Shaykh Albani, rahimahullah, refuting Shaykh Albani, rahimahullah. And half of it is in defense of Sayyid Qutb. So look how these people, Am lakum kitabun fihi tadrusun? Do you have a book which you study? Yani, ajib, these people. Do you have a book which you are studying? That you are going through? How they come to these conclusions? It's Allah salama. But Allah said in the Quran, فَتَرَبَّسُوا حَتَّى يَأْتِيَ أَمْرُ اللَّهِ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَ اللَّهُ بِأَمْرِهِ. Then wait until Allah comes with His command. That you're speaking about the ulama, the likes of Shaykh Albani, rahimahullah, the Jabal, the mountain of knowledge, the one upon the correct aqeedah. فَتَرَبَّسُوا حَتَّى يَأْتِيَ أَمْرُ اللَّهِ أو حَتَّى يَأْتِيَ اللَّهُ بِأَمْرِهِ. Then wait until Allah comes with His command. With His command in dealing with you. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the friend of the ulama, the awliya. And one of the salaf said, if the ulama are not the awliya of Allah, then Allah doesn't have a wali. Then Allah doesn't have a friend. Because the awliya of Allah, لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. No fear for them and no distress for them. Who are they? الذين آمنوا وكانوا يتقون. Those who believe and they were pious, they are the awliya of Allah Azza wa Jal. As in the hadith al-Qudsi, hadith of Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, where the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Allah said, "Man aadha li waliyan faqad aadhantuhu bil harb." Whoever harms a friend of mine, then I'm at war with him. وَمَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدِي بِشَيْءٍ أَحَبَّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّا افْتَرَضْتُ عَلَيْهِ وَلَا يَزَالُ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَافِلِ حَتَّى أُحِبَّهُ فَإِذَا أَحْبَبْتَهُ كُنْتُ سَمْعَهُ الَّذِي يَسْمَعُ بِهِ وبصره الذي يبصر به ويده التي يبطش بها ورجله التي يمشي بها وإذا سألني لأعطينه وإذا استعاذني لأعيذنه. حديث رواه البخاري في صحيحه. This is authentic hadith al-Qudsi showing you who the awliya of Allah are, the friends of Allah, from the anbiya, the righteous, and so on and so forth. Who are they? They fulfill the obligatory duties, tawheed, the fara'id, and they also do the nawafil, the extra duties, until they come close to Allah, until Allah becomes the yani seeing with which they see, the hearing with which they hear. They only hear good things, they only see good things, and the walking which they walk, Allahu Akbar, and the hands in which they feel, yani they only go to that which is good, they only stretch their arms out forward to that which is good, subhanallah. And when they ask of me, then Allah will give them. Allah says, when they ask of me, I will give them. And when they seek refuge of me, I will also protect them. These are the awliya of Allah. The likes of Shaykh Al-Albani, rahimahullah, we consider to be from the ulama. No doubt. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He is from the people in the highest of paradise. Jannat al-Firdaus. And may Allah reward him for what he has put forward for the ummah. Him Ameen, and the rest of the ulama, the likes of Sheikh bin Baz, rahimahullah, and Sheikh ibn Uthaymeen, rahimahullah, from those who have passed away, and Sheikh Muqbil, rahimahullah. May Allah reward them much for their striving and their effort that they have put forward for this ummah in spending their time and effort for guiding the people to Tawheed and Sunnah, guiding the people, the guidance of Bayan wal Irshad, of Bayan, of clarification, and showing the people the way. Wallahi, they have left much khair for us. Volumes and volumes of documented yani, proofs for us to follow, linking us to the people of the past, to the ulama of the past. So Sheikh Albani rahimahullah doesn't need the likes of you and me to defend him. He already defended himself before he died, rahimahullah, and defeated many of those youths who at the head of the century, they were still in school. So how could they be the mujaddidun? Inam, inna Allah yab'athu ala ra'si al-qarn man yujaddidu al-umma umura dinaha. Allah will raise at the head of every century those who revive the deen as a whole. At the head of the century, Sheikh Albani and Sheikh ibn Uthaymeen and Sheikh ibn Baz rahimahullah were in their 60s, already fulfilling much of the deen in their writings and in their da'wah, in aqidah, in iman, and in Islam, the five pillars and the six pillars of belief, and the five pillars of Islam. They already wrote about that at the end of the century. Sheikh Albani did the Usul Sunnah, the check-in, brought out from a manuscript, 1399, before the head of the century by 1 year. Already he's reviving the books of Aqidah. And he wrote Ibn Abi Asim's Kitab al-Sunnah even before that, by about 10, 15 years before that. And other books that he wrote even before that. And some of the books he wrote while he's checking the ahadith, the sanad of the ahadith, yani of the book, on the plane, while he's on his way to Jordan or Syria. Jordan it was at the time. And he mentioned this, for example, in that book called Adam Sama' al-Amwat, that the dead people cannot hear, of Alusi. In the Muqaddimah, if you read the Muqaddimah, you'll see, he says, I've taken this book as a manuscript from Jamia Islamiyah. I've taken it, and here I am checking the book while I'm on the plane on the way to Amman. On the plane, while he's on the way to Amman, he's already going through the book and checking it ahadith. Memorize already the narrators, who they are, and who's who. Subhanallah. Fadl, wallah, fadl. Allah raised him and raised the ulama'ullah. Yarfa'illahu alladhina amanu minkum walladhina utul ilm. Darajat. Allah raised them many levels, wallah. Those ulama, we find that they fear Allah the most. Innama yakhsha Allah min ibadi al-ulama. They're the ones who ascertain, affirm tawheed in their life and in their writings and in their books. Because they're the ones who revive tawheed. Who's reviving tawheed nowadays? Hizb al-Tahrir? Hizb al-Tahrir, all they do is talk about politics. Day and night. This one done, that one did, that one this. That's all they talk about. Where's the Tawheed then? What happened to reviving the belief in Allah Azza wa Jal? And how to believe in Allah? And the Aqeed of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Maybe they fall into Irja, they don't even know it. Or they fall into Takfir, the way the Khawarij, they don't even know it. Who's reviving Tawheed? Jama'at Tabligh? Jama'at Tabligh, they say from their first principle, they say the first principle, which is knowing Allah, is supposed to be Tawheed. So what is it then? Explain to us what the first principle is. They say, the first principle is Tawheed. Okay, what is it? They say, it is to take out the false yaqeen from the heart and put in the sincere yaqeen in the heart. Yani the correct yaqeen in the heart. What is that? Is that Tawheed? That's not Tawheed. Tawheed is, La ma'buda bihaqin illa Allah. This is Tawheed. That none has the right to be worshipped except Allah. And what is Tawheed? Usul al-Iman. Fundamentals of Iman, believing in Allah correctly, believing in the angels correctly, believing in the books correctly, believing in the messengers correctly, believing in the last day correctly, believing in the Qadr correctly, believing in the six beliefs correctly in detail. This is Tawheed. Do they teach that? No. Because they say these things split the people up. So therefore we don't concentrate on usul, we only concentrate on fada'il al-a'mal. So where is Tawheed? In the whole root of Jama'at al-Tabligh, the whole foundation is corrupt. The whole foundation of da'wah. I'm not talking about the normal Tablighi who's going around the street and he's knocking on people's doors. That one probably doesn't know any better. He thinks he's doing good. I'm talking about the whole structure of Jama'at al-Tabligh. The ulama I've mentioned, like Sheikh Hamoud al-Tawajri, rahimahullah, when he refuted them all the way from Medina. And other than him, from the scholars from Riyadh and Mecca, all of them refuting. Sheikh Muhammad al-Banna himself, hafidhahullah, who's from Egypt, and he used to teach in Jamia Islamiyah and in the Jamia in Riyadh, and also in the center and the center of knowledge in Al-Ahsa, and also in Jeddah, and also had a seat in the Haram in Mecca and a seat in the Haram in Medina. And Sheikh Al-Bari rahimahullah used to even attend his class in Medina. And Sheikh Muhammad al-Banna said, and he was a regular student. Even though he says that when Sheikh Al-Bari rahimahullah is around, I keep quiet. This is who said that, Sheikh Muhammad al-Banna. Even though he said that. Sheikh Muhammad al-Banna, hafidhahullah, who's 97 years old in the Hijri calendar, 94 in the Gregorian calendar, he says, even he, hafidhahullah, mentioned, what was I going to say? Before that. Even he said, I went with them once. I went with them to teach them. And there was a leader amongst them, his name was Abdul Ilah. Alhamdulillah, it wasn't me. Abdul Ilah the Tablighi. This one is the Salafi, alhamdulillah. Wallah, he said that. He made me laugh when he said that, but subhanAllah. He said there was a leader amongst them, his name was Abdul Ilah. I was teaching the people the hadith of the man who prayed badly. This leader of the Jamaat Tabligh, Abdulillah al-Tablighi, he came up to me, he says, no, don't teach that. We just tell the people to pray, bas. We don't tell the people how to pray. We don't tell the people how to believe in Allah, how to believe in the angels, how to believe in the last day, and so on and so forth. Allah explained how. And those things we don't know how, we don't go into. But Allah already explained how to worship Him. Allah already explained, don't go to the graves and call upon the dead. Allah already explained, don't go to the peer and ask for his help when he's in his grave dead. He needs more help than you. He can't even lift, the Sheikh Abdul Muhsin says, he can't even lift the soil that is above his head. And he's going to help you. Subhanallah. So Sheikh Muhammad al-Banna went with them and he tried, and then they said, no, don't do this. We don't have this. So he left them. And the same with Ikhwan al-Muslimin. Ikhwan al-Muslimin, the same thing. They have a motto, and their motto is what? The da'wah of Hassan al-Banna, Sayyid Qutb, all of those. Their motto is, نَتَعَاوَنُوا فِي مَا تَفَقْنَا عَلَيْهِ وَيُعْذِرُوا بَعْضُنَا بَعْضًا فِي مَا اخْتَلَفْنَا فِيهِ. We cooperate in those things we agree upon, and those things which don't agree upon, we will excuse each other. Taba'an, on issues of fiqh, this is okay. Everyone brings its proof, no problem. But what about aqeedah? We excuse each other in aqeedah. They left a motto like that. نَتَعَاوَنُ فِي مَا تَفَقْنَا عَلَيْهِ وَيُعْدِرُوا بَعْضُنَا بَعْضًا فِي مَا اخْتَلَفْنَا فِيهِ. Allah. And those things that you differ on in aqeedah, no problem. No problem. Nasallahu salama. And that's why they have no, that's why Hamas, the Ikhwan, from the Ikhwan Muslimin, they have no problem in cooperating with the Shia, the Rafida, who curse the companions and say that the companions, all of them became murtad, kuffar, disbelievers, except Ahlul Bayt. They have no problem in cooperating with them. Nasallahu salama. Shuft kayf al-aqidah muhimma. See how aqidah is so important. You see how the people diluted aqidah, and they want to refute Sheikh Al-Bani rahimahullah. How can you even reach Sheikh Al-Bani rahimahullah's nails for what he has done in the da'wah, in reviving the books of Tawheed and Sunnah? Wallahi, Sheikh Al-Bani rahimahullah. And the people of Fadl know the people of Fadl. Sheikh bin Baz rahimahullah, muhaddith, faqih, and he sent, and he's thanking Sheikh Al-Bani rahimahullah for checking the hadith of checking the sanad of Musnad Imam Ahmad. Jazakallah khair. Because he sent it first of all to the ulama of India. The ulama of India said, it's not for us. They sent it to Sheikh Al-Bani rahimahullah. Sheikh bin Baz rahimahullah was the head of Jamia Islamiyah. at that time, in the golden years, as Sheikh Muhammad al-Banna calls it, the golden years, 1382, 1383, the golden years. Because at that time, you had the kibar ulama from around the world teaching in Jamia Islamiya, the golden years. Sheikh al-Albani, rahimahullah, they chose. He had no certificate, secondary certificate, no degree certificate, no master's certificate, no PhD certificate, but he had his books. He had his ilm to show, to prove who he was. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised him. So Sheikh bin Baz rahimahullah chose him to be in charge of setting up the curriculum of hadith in the Islamic University of Medina. That's Sheikh Albani rahimahullah. At that time, and Sheikh Albani speaks even about that time. He said, wallahi, look, I became so busy. I was glad the contract ended because I wanted to get back to my work. 3 years of being there, he was glad it ended because he got occupied, he said, and I wanted to get back to my work of what? Of going through the ahadith, checking the ahadith in the four sunans, as well as in the other books of aqidah and fiqh, going through those words, ahadith, painstakingly going through them, and compiling a sahiha, more than 5, 6, 7,000 hadith, and a da'ifa likewise. Thousands of ahadith, going through them painstakingly, each one with commentary. Allahu Akbar. Hakada ulama, spending their time with that which is beneficial, Allah. Ni'matan maghbunun fihima kathiru minan nas, as-sihhatu wal-faraq. Two things people waste most: free time and their good health. And it's so true. And the ulama gave importance to that. And yet they have... And notice, look, subhanAllah, you find those who have takfiri tendencies, they will say that Ahl Sunnah are murji. SubhanAllah. And those who have irja tendencies, they will accuse Ahl Sunnah of takfir. But alhamdulillah, Ahl Sunnah in the middle course, in between the takfiriyin and in between the murji'ah.